Harley Quinn is getting the red carpet treatment in honor of 25 years of mayhem. From a 25th anniversary special to a Batman Day takeover this Saturday. Paul Dini, the man who helped create Harley, is here to celebrate a quarter century of the clown princess of crime. Now, Harley Quinn turns 25 years old this month. How does it feel to have created such an iconic character? And did you think that Harley Quinn would be still around today?
No, I mean, I had no idea. She seemed like a fun character to just throw in there for a few episodes. And it was fun to write her. Tim came up with a really tremendous design for her. And Arlene Sorkin, my friend, came up with a really great voice for her. And it was just one of those fun things. And she worked really well in Joker's favor. And then we dropped her for a few episodes. And then I thought, well, the Joker needs a gang again, so I'm gonna bring her back for Laughing Fish. And after that, she just seemed to have a little sparkle to her. She wasn't just a rank and file hench person. There seemed to be a way to take her in different directions where she and the Joker would have some energy together, which is always what you look for.
Now, the Harley Quinn 25th anniversary special is out now. Can you tell us a little bit about your story in it?
Sure, my story is called Birthday Blues, and it's about Harley's lousy luck with her birthdays, going back to when she was about 5 years old. So we see a little window into her childhood, into her family life, which wasn't all that hot. And then right up until the present day with the Joker, and she's on the phone talking to Poison Ivy and saying, "Tonight's the night, Red, dining, dancing, and sweet romance, and Mr. J promised." And of course, he breaks the promise right away, and leaving her crestfallen, still on the phone with Poison Ivy. And it's what happens after that while she tries to throw herself a sad little birthday party.
Now, you've also got another team up. Yep. You have Harley and Ivy meet Betty and Veronica. That's coming up. Can you tell us a little bit about that and what it's like teaming up these duos from different universes?
Well, it's great. These are four of my favorite female characters of all time. And it's tremendous just to bring them into the same world and have them share adventures. And I can't really go into the specifics, but ultimately it's Mr. Lodge is in the process of doing something that is going to wreak havoc with the ecosystem near Riverdale, and that raises Poison Ivy's ire, and Harley is along to support her pal, and along the way gets entranced with the idea of going back to high school again.
Now, other than your own, are there any Harley stories or versions of Harley over the last 25 years that you really enjoy, you really like?
I like them all. I like when Bruce Timm takes her and does a solo story with her. I love it when I liked her in Suicide Squad. I thought that it was great seeing that little bit of the Joker-Harley relationship, and I thought Margot Robbie did a great job. You can see she was having a lot of fun with the character. I love what Jimmy and Amanda are doing with her in the books. It's all fun.
Now, what are you doing to celebrate Harley's takeover of Batman Day this Saturday?
I am appearing at the Barnes & Noble at the Grove here in LA and having a Q&A and a signing from about 5 to 7. That should be fun. There'll be a lot of fans there. We wanted to have cake, but the insurance wouldn't cover it, so no cake. Sorry. And just kicking back and talking all things Harley and Batman.
Now, is there anything you would want to say to the fans of Harley Quinn who are watching right now?
Haven't you had enough? No. I thank you for embracing the kid. Thank you for keeping her working. And as long as I can, I'll try and come up with entertaining things for her to do.
That's a look at the legacy of Harley Quinn. And here's every new DC comic you can pick up starting tomorrow. That's the news for now, but if you're lagging behind on some of your favorite Rebirth titles, you can get a double dose of my favorite, Dick Grayson, with new collected editions of Nightwing and Titans. See you tomorrow, Super Friends.